Today I'm here at the Suds and Shine Car Wash, automatic touchless one wash car, truck, and RV. So as you can see, our car is probably one of the most dirtiest times it's actually probably ever gotten dirty like this. So as you can see, this is how dirty the car is. I just cannot believe how dirty the car is. But yeah, so it's really, really dirty. So anyways, let's do this. Okay, so I'm on. Remember, I'm gonna be going in the back seat for 1 second, so I can like take the cable and everything, so I can do like the PlayStation and everything. No, in the back seat. You know how you pull up enough, and I'm in the back seat, and I do that. No, mom. All right. So this is a laser wash G5 with a really rare PlayStation that's mostly in the USA. So mom,
yes,
see this seat that I'm sitting in?
Yeah.
You know how you usually do that where you pull up and up and I roll down this window and then I do the payment and everything and you select the wash and everything?
Well, let's see if there's enough room. I can't always guarantee.
Well, there's no gate or anything, so. Alright, so let's just head up, and this is a laser wash G5. No, mom, don't roll down your window. No, yeah, I know, but mom, pull up enough so that I can do it. No, mom, you have to.
Oh, careful.
You have to select the wash first.
Okay, that's a truck wash, baby.
Please add payment for your selection.
Okay, add your payments. Oh wait, the audio. Alright. So, drive forward. Holy crap, that's a tight clearance.
Don't say crap.
I know.
Apologize to your viewers.
And besides, I think this is an old G5 because as you can see, it has the old laser dry dryers. So the reason why I chose the laser wash G5 is because, well no, I chose this because it's a touch free and as I think as most of you guys know, that most touch-free systems can only remove light dirt. Why is the machine not doing anything? This is weird. Oh, there we go. Alright, so start off with a pre-stock. Not a very good coverage, but on the top it was a nice coverage. And on the sides, not very good coverage. I'm not sure if this is blue coral pre-stock or what, but it's kind of blurred. It's like faded. The thing that says laser wash G5 touch free trademark. You know what I mean? You guys know what I mean, right? Oh, sorry if I'm filming horribly. I do that sometimes. I don't know why I do that. So the pre-soak is soaking. I don't know why I don't see the sign lighting up. This is weird. It's a pretty nice sunny day today, though. It's, for the whole week in my city, it's gonna be a really nice, So we got an extra pass of pre-soak. See, if you look closely, this machine doesn't look like it's hardly even new. Now, the weird thing about the G5s is as you can see, like, the arm is turned at a certain angle. It's kind of weird whenever it's ran like that. So it's done that now. Wipers on, please. And as you can see, there are the cables and everything. But hopefully my camera doesn't stop going. Else I ain't going to be happy one single bit. So you might be able to tell that there's an old laser, laser wash you got, because as you can see, this has old laser dry dryers. Like I found in the Laser Wash 4000 at the Cherry Grove Husky and Inventory. I don't know if you guys knew this, but sorry if I said 360 degrees on my last video of a laser wash and dry. But these actually aren't 360 degree nozzles. They actually are 0 degree nozzles. Oh, great, my camera is blurry. What's this? Okay, empty pass. It's kind of funny when it goes an empty pass. So my guess is it's the Triton now. Yep. It was spraying the top of the arm. Mom, I don't know if you saw that, but it was spraying Triton on the top of the arm. I don't know if any of you guys saw that, but it was spraying Triton on the side, on the top of the arm. 4:39 p.m. Right now, that's what the time is. High pressure rinse. My guess in Texas was it would probably be 5:39 p.m. in Texas right now. If it was in Texas, then it would definitely be 5:39. Stuff. I can't tell if the car is still dirty or not, but might be, I don't know. Because the last time I went to an old V5, it did a horrible job. Like, the cover Capri-Soak was the worst cover Capri-Soak ever. Like, I did not like that one at all. Not even 1%. What's this? Now, this is actually the sign that's doing this. It's not really showing the cycle up. My guess is it's sweat for rain or something. Yeah, it smells kind of nice. I hear the dryers. The only cycle that lights up is the laser dry. Oh, I thought the door wouldn't open. Slow, slow, slow. So we have 75 seconds of dryer time. I didn't know that was, you can go slow now. Okay, so now let's park. Oh, come on. Thank you. Gosh, I wasn't able to get out of the car first. Okay, yeah, mostly with these laser dry dryers, I usually have a guess that they're not gonna do a good job. So actually, that did a pretty awesome job. But I'm not really impressed on the sides, if you look. Not I'm hardly impressed with on the sides, because the car is a bit still dirty on the sides. Those up there, that's still dirty. Anyways, I wouldn't really trust this wash. If I would do a revisit,
it did
maybe
an excellent job on the back.
Yeah, it did a pretty. I haven't seen the back yet, but did a really nice job drying the windshield. I don't know why that door is all black on the outside though. It's really weird. But anyways, it smells kind of nice. It smells really nice. But holy moly, the dryers didn't do very good on the bottom of like the back of the vehicle. Well, hope you guys enjoyed this this video of this PDQ Laserwatch T5 here at this Southern Shine Car Wash. As you can see, make sure you subscribe to my channel, give all my videos a like, and have a good day.